poor Stevie by.
Steve O'Donnell was the gentleman, so everybody said. He was loved by all his friends, both rich and poor.
Even the police.
And everyone felt sorry when they heard that Steve was dead. And they saw the piece that crept upon the door.
Especially those the old money.
The barber came to shave the Galway slugger from his throat. And cut his hair in a la pompadour.
Would have cut his throat last night.
A red necktie and buttonhole bouquet was in his coat. And a bunch of shamrocks in his hand he wore.
He looked so natural.
Undertaker Feeney had the job to lay O'Donnell out.
Every Saturday
in
night.
In a casket of the very finest make.
That was the best pine.
He dressed the corpse in broadcloths. That boys, there'll be no doubt that they'll all get drunk at Steve O'Donnell's way. That they were fighters and biters and Irish dynamiters. There was beer, gin, whiskey, wine and cake. There were men in high positions. There were Irish politicians. And they all got drunk at Steve O'Donnell's wake. There were 50 candles at his head and 20 at his feet.
He was well lit.
Plenty flowers sent for friendship's sake.
Pretty.
Oh, Steve, me by, way did you die? The weeping we all cried. And we all felt sad at Steve O'Donnell's wake.
He stopped breathing.
Mike McGovern said that Steve O'Donnell was an awful bum.
Knew him well.
But of course he only meant it for a joke.
Oh, I suppose.
But Paddy Mac got up his back and he made McGovern run because he hit him in the eye an awful poke.
And left him to death.
Then all joined in the fighting then because everyone was mad. And blood enough was spilled to form a lake.
Ah, they had a wonderful time.
They knocked corpse down on the floor and blew out all the lights. There was murder down at Steve O'Donnell's wake. That they were fighters and biters and Irish dynamiters. There was beer, gin, whiskey, wine and cake. There were men in high positions. There were Irish politicians. And they all got drunk at Steve O'Donnell's wake. Then the cops came in to stop the brawl to make them understand.
They wanted to.
And the corpse was picked up by his brother Dan.
Picked up by the cops last week.
And someone stole the necktie from around O'Donnell's throat. Yeah. Mike McGovern says O'Reilly was the man.
Oh, really?
O'Reilly's friends got crazy mad and swore they'd have his life. McGovern saw he made a great mistake.
He was married too.
They fought and fought and danced around until the cops came in and arrested all at Steve O'Donnell's wake.
It was a nice ride.
They were fighters and biters and Irish dynamiters. There was beer, gin, whiskey, wine and cake. There were men in high positions. There were Irish politicians and they all got drunk at Steve O'Donnell's wake. And they all got drunk at Steve O'Donnell's.